That was his name that he used. That was his family name. And when we look at the etymology of this word, it comes from a clan of Anderson. It's actually a surname, the last name, deriving from the patriotic meaning son of Anders or son of Andrews. And it itself essentially derived from the Greek name Andreas, meaning man. So Anderson means son of man. And you thought I was playing semantics when I told you that Neo actually represented Christ. Morpheus represent God the Father, and Trinity represented the Holy Spirit. I mean, there was a scene when Neo actually died, and Trinity, the Holy Spirit, breathed back the breath of life into Neo, bringing him back to life, because she was a depiction of the Holy God, the Holy Spirit, this Trinity that they teach in Roman Catholicism. So Neo essentially means the son of man. So in it actually originated in the British Isles of the Nordic countries. So Anderson is the son of man, meaning Christ, Yahusha. So Neo's straw man in the movie Matrix was actually the son of man. But when, while he was in the Matrix, he wasn't aware of this because he was asleep. He was just like all of the other ostrich with the head in the sand. And then all of those that were shaking their hands were the agents and the people that was actually controlling the Matrix. But everyone else, 99% of the people, had their heads in the sand, bumping into other people, not really knowing what was truly going on. So that was Neo's stance. So all people like our brothers in IUIC that do not realize that democracy, because if you listen to IUIC, they speak in favor of the government on the one half. They speak in favor of the government. Why? Because IUIC, and this may hurt many of you that's part of this organization, IUIC is a 501c3 chattel warehouse. And if you're one of the members, you are actually human cargo that's warehoused under the 501c3 grant. So you cannot speak out against government. Now notice that IUIC would speak ill about Esau in general, but why is it they do not speak out against democracy? In fact, there's videos with many of their members saying, I would snitch on you, I would tell the cops on you, and so on and so forth. How can they be for democracy, and for the Most High also? I'll tell you how. It's because IUIC, like so many others, caught up in this matrix. And the matrix is what we're living right now today. What you're living is an illusion. What we're trying to teach you is the truth. But you keep fighting the truth. You keep rejecting the truth. You keep bucking up against the truth. Because like IUIC, so many people, 99% of the people, do not realize that democracy is merely a war zone control of combatants that are deceived by this world and those that are not truly seeing the real truth, the unadulterated truth. So the people of the Matrix are programmed to be happy without a care in the world. They have no independent thought or ability to alter or change their commercial or political system. I'm talking about 99% of the people on the planet today is in the matrix, and they live with their heads in the sand like an ostrich, and have no clue what's really going on. Now, watch this. If you are members of IUIC, tell me that you haven't been told not to go on the internet, watch other Israelites, don't read such and such, don't listen to so and so. And I warn you, brothers and sisters, I'm warning you, anyone that tells you don't read this, don't listen to that, that is known as tyranny. That is a tyrannical church. That is a tyrannical leader and a tyrannical government, essentially becoming a de facto. So the people are actually programmed by the silver screens. They're programmed by the false news media. Most of the media that you receive today is false. They mix the truth with lies to deceive you. They're programmed by the talking heads. These are the people that's controlling the matrix. Your red childs, rough childs, your Rockefellers, your universities and public food systems, they program you. See, they're slaves because they do not understand the question, why? I don't care, they may be doctors, they may be teachers, they may be professors, they may be scientists, but they are slaves because they do not comprehend the question, why? Folks, I want you to hear me well. All Hollywood movies are parables. All Hollywood movies are parables. They're telling you something. They're describing the current realities that you think is just fiction. But you're living in their matrix that they've actually created. They are describing the current realities that you overlook because you're blinded. I hate to talk to you this way, but I gotta tell you the truth because I love you, brother, sister. So in the Matrix, they confuse most people because the movies was actually depicted in a backwards manner. Remember now, this world is primarily controlled by Illuministic figures and masonry. And in 1776, 2 days ago, the 4th of July, 1776 was celebrated. And you think that was when America got her freedom. What they was essentially celebrating is when the barbarian Illuminati infiltrated masonry overhead under Adam Weishaupt. So remember, these people do everything backwards. Albert Pike says, as above is below. You reverse everything around when you're dealing with these people. So when they put out the movie The Matrix Revolution, which is actually the third Matrix movie, the last movie begins with the United States of America Constitution of 1787. But watch this. The first movie begin in the present times, but the last movie, they took you back to 1787 in the Organic Constitution. See, they reversed it on you and you missed it. So you gotta be a special kind of man ordained by the Most High to be able to see these things. So the Matrix was a system that warehoused living souls in a coma-like state. Many of these Israelite camps out here, some of them, they warehouse their subjects in a coma-like state. Well, if you're not here, you're not in the truth. So the Most High is only dealing with you, brother? Is that what you're saying? You gotta watch that kind of talk, brothers. The living beings in the Matrix were fed neurological impulses into their brains that gave them this false perception of reality in their brains, that they were actually living a normal life, like they was going to work, like they was married in relationships, and like they was, you know, spending time with their families. And at no time did these living beings that was actually in this coma-like state realize that they were not leading or living a real life of choice. They was programmed, but praise be the Most High. I was able to be blessed to see through this. But the Matrix was not just a movie. This is the life that the people are actually living today. You are caught up in the Matrix and you look at me as if I'm crazy. So you question everything myself and others that's actually trying to deprogram you and enlighten you, tell you. But you go with the system, you know why? Because everyone else does it, so it must be right. Tazadaq and a few other people are saying this, so it can't be right. Program. Subliminal suggestions. They're programming you. Subliminal suggestions. You've been engineered to think the way that they have you thinking. See, praise be the Most High. I know they reject us, the small few that's really teaching this. I don't mean the ones out there just like ripping people off and, you know, just scamming their brothers and sisters. That's not a creditor. I don't care how much money or whatever you're getting. That's not a creditor. If you're creating arguments, you want to fight, that's not a creditor. A creditor is actually in harmony. He's about bringing peace. That's what a creditor is. And I try and emphasize this to people. Don't go in the court arguing because you're going through door two. If you're an argument, you get into an argument, that's what debtors do. That's what attorneys do. You're going to lose. You go in the acquiescence. You go silent. You say nothing. You're going to lose. That's dishonor. But if you agree with your adversary quickly, as the scriptures say, you're in harmony. Or if you conditionally accept the offer, I conditionally accept your offer upon proof of claim, that you prove up your claim, you're still in harmony. You're giving them an option. There's no argument. Debtors argue. So praise be the Most High that when I and you, brother, appear to be a reject, we know that we're beginning to travel down the right path because many rejected Yahweh Shah. They rejected Christ.